Dogumentary TV, producing the best breed documentaries on YouTube.
Hey, what's going on? This is Zeke, Dogumentary TV, and this is the YouTube channel for dog lovers. Earlier this week, I did a live reaction video to a video posted the 10 most intimidating guard dogs. I thought the list which was posted on Viral B, I thought it was pretty solid, but not as tight as what I feel like a Dogumentary TV list would be. So in this video, I'm going to give you guys the 10 most intimidating guard dog breeds. I'm basing my list off of the fact that these dogs have a very strong visual deterrent, meaning they look intimidating. That's what intimidation is about. When you look at something and it pretty much deters you from doing anything that you shouldn't be doing, taking advantage of someone that you shouldn't be taking advantage of. In addition to, you know, looking the part, I also chose dogs that are very capable of guarding. It was a combination of high visual deterrence as well as impeccable guarding abilities. For that reason, a breed like the Belgian Malinois, which is an excellent guard dog, won't be on this list because it doesn't have the visual deterrence of some of the breeds that are on this list. All right, guys, let's start at number 10. My number 10 dog is a Cane Corso. The Cane Corso, it comes from Italy. It's a dog that basically has a genetic history of guarding and protecting the farm. This dog not only guarded against 2-foot predators, but it also guarded against animals. Today, the Cane Corso is proven to be a very athletic, intelligent, and capable guardian. For that reason, it's my number 10 dog. Number 9 on my list of the most intimidating guard dog breeds is the Doberman Pinscher. Obviously, the Doberman Pinscher is the only dog breed that was ever created for the specific purpose of personal protection. Today, the Doberman Pinscher is a very intelligent, super athletic, and capable guardian dog breed. This breed has what I would consider to be an elite mix of athleticism and size. For a dog that can be about 100 pounds, in addition to that, the breed is very smart, very intuitive, and not only is a Doberman Pinscher a great protector and guardian, it's also a wonderful companion. Number 8 on my list of most intimidating guard dogs is the Rottweiler. These dogs are amazing, instinctually, genetically programmed for protection. Rottweilers are instinctively aloof, always wary of strangers, and very much aware of their boundaries. Being a Rottweiler owner myself, I can say that my Rottweiler puppy, who's about 16 months now, has already identified the boundaries of my property as things that he will defend. Without me even engaging him in any kind of training, anybody who kind of steps foot on the property line or comes near a gate will get barked at, will be made aware of his presence. In addition to being instinctually adept at guarding, the breed is visually intimidating. You know, roughly 125 pounds, 26, 27 inches tall, black, huge head. The Rottweiler is a very imposing figure. Speaking from personal experience, anytime your Rottweiler is by your side, people will ask for permission to approach you or your property. The number 7 dog on my list of most intimidating guard dogs is the Presser Canario. Very similar to the Cane Corso, the Presser Canario is a farm dog of rustic origins. Has innate guarding instincts, excellent athleticism, athletic dogs. These dogs will provide great protection of person and property, and even livestock if you have some. Presser Canario, like I said, is very much in the same vein as the Cane Corso. Presser is higher on this list because it is a little bit more rustic, a little bit less kennel club affected, meaning the genetics are a little bit more truer to their origination, and therefore I feel that the instincts and intensity of the Presser Canario is a little bit higher than in the Cane Corso and even in the Rottweiler. Number 6 on my list is a Serbian defense dog. This is a recreation of the old Serbian Mastiff. The breed is basically a Mastiff hybrid, and recreating the breed, the creators use Serbian wolves, working Bosnian Tornjaks, German Rottweilers, Neapolitan Mastiff, American Staffordshire Terriers, and game-bred Pit Bulls. This amalgamation of dog breeds have created in the Serbian defense dog a breed that is has amazing physical strength, fantastic guarding instincts, and impressive fighting abilities. The Serbian defense dog is a versatile molosser capable of handling a great number of duties with ease, as well as being a wonderful urban companion for responsible dog owners. In addition to all these amazing genetic instincts and attributes for guarding, the Serbian defense dog has a very high visual deterrence. This breed is not a breed that you're going to walk up on and want to engage in any kind of altercation. All right, guys, number five on my list of the 10 most intimidating guard dog breeds is a Tibetan Mastiff. Now, the Tibetan Mastiff is a huge dog breed, and their size is only exaggerated in some types of Tibetan Mastiff by their mane, their fur, their hair, whatever you want to call it. These dogs can look ferocious. Genetically speaking, Tibetan Mastiffs are territorial and are natural guardian dogs. Some Tibetan Mastiffs can be more protective about guarding and watchdog work than others, but typically the breed is highly territorial, very confident, and not only will this breed stand its ground, it will close the distance between itself and a perceived threat. A word of caution when it comes to owning a Tibetan Mastiff: because of their history and the way they were used, this breed is very independent and can be very stubborn. Number four on my list, South African Mastiff, also known as the Furball. The Furball is a dog breed that was developed in Southern Africa and without a doubt has faced just environmentally some of the toughest adversaries, not only men, but you're talking wild animals like leopards, even lions. I'm not saying that these dogs engage lions or leopards in that matter in terms of combat, but they had to develop the resolve to hold their ground, to bark, to make noise, and to stand in the face of an apex predator. In regards to this breed's ability to be a guard dog, genetically, it's all there. The dog has guarded and worked on the farms in Southern Africa since its inception. In terms of its visual deterrence, the breed is huge, the head is blocky, the bark is deep. The Furball is the epitome of elite size and elite strength when it comes to canines. All right, guys, the Fila Brasileiro, which is the Brazilian Mastiff. This breed is a breed that needs much exercise and will become frustrated or excessively aggressive if they aren't exercised well. Filas were used to guard estates, and they were also used in the hunting of big game animals such as jaguar. The dogs would also work with livestock, driving cattle, as well as catching individual cattle when the Brazilian rancher needed a cattle to be caught. A very courageous dog, very powerful Mastiff. It is amiable with its human family, making a very loyal and loving companion to its family. This breed is extremely dedicated to its owner. Fila will protect you without a moment's hesitation. The breed feels that that is its purpose. Once you bond with your Fila, you and your family will become its whole world. You will never have to teach your Fila to protect you. He will do this on his own. My number two dog on my list of the 10 most intimidating guard dogs is the Bully Cutter. Now, this breed is on my list, so high on my list, based on personal experience. There has been no other dog breed that has, I would say, more so intimidated me than a Bully Cutter. Now, typically this is a fighting dog breed and it's known for its aggressiveness, it's known for being territorial. It's not necessarily known in terms of its history as being a typical guard dog in a way that we think of in terms of Western civilization. Like, I don't know how trainable these dogs are, but genetically speaking, they have all the guarding instincts, very protective of their people, very protective of property, of their surroundings. The breed has an extremely loud bark. It's a huge dog, so the visual deterrence of the Bully Cutter is immense. I mean, you're looking at a dog that could weigh 180 pounds, easy. Muscle, big head, loud bark, and very aggressive. And these dogs, like I said, these are fighting dogs, so they're not dogs that are going to back down from animal or human. They will hold their ground. And just face it, no one's going to jump a fence. No one's going to engage huge, massive dog that's barking at them. It's just not going to happen. Number one dog breed on my list, the Caucasian Shepherd. This breed historically was trained for guarding and safekeeping of herds, livestock, human dwellings, protecting them from both human and animal predators. The breed is recognized by the FCI as a guard dog and watchdog. Caucasian Shepherds are a large, powerful, and naturally aggressive guard dog. The dog is strong-willed, very loyal, fearless, capable guard dog, suitable for protecting large areas such as commercial estates. These dogs are known to work in prisons as well as working with the military. Aside from the genetic predisposition to be intensely territorial, the breed is relatively athletic. In terms of temperament, it is very aloof, very wary of strangers. It is intense, and in my estimation, the optimal or the ultimate guard dog in terms of looks and guarding ability. Not a dog breed that you can train in the Western sense of the word of dog protection sports or guarding sports. This is more of a dog that you would basically place with an understanding that the dog will form its own genetic understanding, genetically will form its understanding of what boundaries belong to it. It will understand what people are part of its family, and those people are to be protected. I've seen a lot of people work with Caucasian Shepherds on sleeves and doing other kind of protection type activities with the Caucasian Shepherd. And I don't think this is a dog breed whose guarding intelligence rivals that of a Belgian Malinois. But in terms of its visual presentation, I'm going to do my best to avoid this 150-pound monster. All right, guys, so there you go. That's my list. I think it's a very solid list. If you guys have something that you want to add or you want to detract from, or do you have an opinion, go ahead and leave it in the comment section. All right, guys, this is Zeke. This is Dogumentary TV. Peace.